And welcome to Common Sense TV. I'm your host, the doctor of Common Sense, E.T. Williams. That's right. Islam is over there beating you for not praying. That's what they're doing. I'm your host, the doctor of Common Sense, E.T. Williams. Please visit the website at www.whateverhappenedtocommonsense.com. There also, you can get all your Amazon needs at the website, www.whateverhappenedtocommonsense.com. You know, I don't know if you've heard about this story. It comes out of Syria. We have the Islamization process being accelerated over in Syria. On Friday, they publicly beat and gave two men 25 lashes. Guess what their crime was? No, it's not sleeping with little eight-year-olds. That's acceptable. No, it's not chopping the infidel's head off. That's acceptable. No, it's not blowing up churches. That's fine and dandy if you blow up churches. No, it's not maiming and killing people for no reason. No, it's not raping and torturing women. Their crime was, guess what? They refused to pray in public. Yeah, it was a sounding of the gong saying prayer time, and these bunch of infidels who had been hanging around infidel, they supposed to be Islamic, but evidently the cry went out for prayer on Friday, and these two men did not send the proper prayer. Maybe they was pointed in the wrong direction when they was praying, but whatever the case may be, the Islamic peaceful people over in Halib decided that we need to make a example out of these boys. The prayer bell went off for you to pray, and it was reported to us that you two fellas were not praying, so we're going to have a public caning of you. 25 lashes, raise your shirt up, get on your knees, get on the ground. We're going to cane you in public to show example for these other folks, to let you know when the bell rings, we want prayer being displayed out here, damn it. That's right, in front of everybody. Everybody else stood there peacefully and watched the public caning of these fellas for their crime of not praying in public. We will not tolerate this. Now, over in our country, you may get caned for praying. Over in Syria, in the Islamic, the religion of peace is saying that for not praying, you're going to get caned in public. I wonder what the liberals got to say about this. They should love this story. They are getting caned for not praying. That's right. They put them out there on display, told them, raise your shirt up. They said some words in Aramaic, I guess. I don't know what language they were speaking in. You can see the link below on the website. And when they put them out there, told them to raise their shirt up, one fellow was sticking his hand back. You know how you used to do when your mama used to whoop you? Now, put your hand up. You better not hold your hand up. He tried to put his hand back in the back of his back to stop that cane. And he said, move your hand down. Bye, y'all. Move your hand. Pow. I said, move your hand down. This is for Allah. Bam. Was beating him right there. I wonder was his kids, did his kids and his, maybe their wives had to watch him getting caned, and all his friends and loved ones watch this public humiliation of these two men of the crime of not praying in public. Hold on a minute. We're not finished with you. I'm going to give you one to grow because you was holding your hands back there. That's what they did. But they are so peaceful. I wonder why the liberal media never get outraged for these type of action. Now, where's Barack Obama and Senator McCain, John Lindsay, all these fellas? What about Mr. Lutz himself, Mr. John Kerry? They were saying these folks, the rebels, were peaceful people. John McCain even said, just like you pray to your God, when they say Eskanu al-Akbar, that means you just praying to your God. These are peaceful people. And the only reason they came, matter of fact, they had it coming. They were deserving of this public caning by not praying to Allah. When the bell sounded, it says prayer time. And when it says prayer time, you pray. Hold on a minute. I said, did you hear that bell ring? You didn't hear the bell ring, huh? Come on out here to the public square. They announced it. The crowd was gathered around, and they pulled out the cane. told the men to raise their shirt. They took their beating just right there in public. Either you can take this beating or you can get your head chopped off. They're so loving. Oh, they are loving people. Just get right here on your knees. And this is the religion of peace. Beat them right there for not praying in public. Now, I wonder, is the president going to say something about this? Is he still in Hawaii? I heard he has left Hawaii. And he's on his way back because he left Michelle there. She was still going to celebrate her 50th birthday while the president finished a friendly game of golf. He and the girls caught a private jet, Air Force One or something, came on back because it's about time for him to pretend like he's going to do some work. Because even when he's at work, he's on vacation because he's either campaigning or doing something that has nothing to do with America's business. But the president came back. Now, could somebody stick a microphone in his face and ask him, what do you think about these peaceful rebels over there in Syria? This is not the government doing. These are the peaceful rebels, the insurgents, the peaceful one that McCain talked about, how peaceful they were. They said, you're going to get this public caning for not praying. Punks jump up and get beat down. That's right, the religion of peace, beating you for not praying.